Okay, and now I will start my rant against Excel, because I know many of you are still doing statistics in Excel, and it's really not a good idea. There is alternative software available. We have Prism. For VIB scientists, Prism is free. You can use it for free, and it's so easy to use. It's as easy as Excel. Why not use Excel? Because of a number of things. And I will show a few examples. So when you import gene symbols or gene names, identifiers, into Excel, Excel will automatically change them and convert them to dates or floating point numbers. And what is the most frustrating thing here, once Excel has made that change, there's no way to convert back. So you lose these G names and these identifiers forever. DEC2, for instance, it's an existing gene. Excel will automatically transform it into December the 2nd. And it's gone. Well, here you can still retrieve what it was, but sometimes there's no way to see what the original G name or identifier was. So it's so annoying. And Excel knows it for years. It has been published and they're not doing anything about it. It's so annoying that scientists are doing it themselves. They are renaming all the genes to make sure that this thing will no longer happen, this issue. And that's really sad, isn't it? If Excel isn't doing anything and scientists have to solve it. And it's not only that. You have the issues that are specific for the biological field with the gene names, but there's also general issues with Excel. And the most well-known example is this one here. So it was published on a blog and the title was "Should We Ban Excel?" So it's that bad. So it's about two Harvard professors who published a study based on analysis of values in Excel, and who concluded that the best thing to do to save an economy is to be very strict and to not spend money, but to save money. There was one PhD student who thought, "Now, I think that's strange. I'm going to do that analysis again." So he asked for the data, he got the data, he analyzed it, and he came to completely different conclusions. Why? Well, because the two professors, you know that in Excel, when you want to tell him which numbers you want to use for a formula, you can select them with your mouse. Now, for some reason, that didn't go well for these professors, and they forgot to select the first, 30 or 40 lines of the Excel sheet. So they lost information on all the countries that start with A, B, C, and D. So China was not there, Canada was not there, Belgium was not there. A lot of countries were not there in their calculations. So their results were not correct. And if that PhD student had never checked it, no one would ever know that there was a big mistake there. So in Excel, it's easy to do stuff, but it also invites you to make a lot of mistakes, mistakes that you will not notice, and that's the worst thing. So don't use Excel. There are websites where you can find a lot of discussions about Excel. So here's an example on the amount of money that was lost because of errors made by analyzing data in Excel files. So please do not use Excel, but use Prism or R or SAS or